So I'd like to welcome you to our second cooking class this season. We had one cooking class that was a bread making class, basically, on February 26th. Some of you have been for that class, and I hope you enjoyed. I know some responses. Some people already tried to make their own bread, which is very encouraging, and I think it's good for you and your families, by the way. That's healthy, and that's a good step forward. So for those who missed that class, we could provide the recipe and some more information what was presented for that class. Now, today we are going to have four recipes, as you see in the recipe book. So as you see, there is going to be like beans, protein, vegetables, and all of this combined, and at the end some dessert. So this is like a meal, okay? So you can have it for lunch when you combine, because we should balance our diet. We should not go to extremes, you know, like somebody eats only carrots or only apples, right? So we should be balanced, and that's why you'll get in the soup, you'll get the beans and some vegetables, and then in the other recipes, you'll get them in the sausages, in the vegan sausages. Actually, you also have beans, you have protein, and other ingredients which are listed in your recipe. So I'm glad to see all of you and the ones who are for the first time. So I'd like to invite today. So the first recipe will come is the vegetable bean soup. So Rita, we'll have three ladies, they will present the recipes today. So first we'll go Rita, and she will present the first recipe. So we hope you enjoy.
Now we are all set. Welcome to our second cooking class, and I'd like to present the vegetable bean soup. This soup is very easy to prepare. It takes about maybe 40 minutes, maximum 1 hour if you are slower to cutting all the beans. And we will start with our chopped carrots. You can chop in any size or any shape, but I like to be smaller so it looks nice. I cut it like in quarter, small little pieces. And we're gonna put the carrots with about 2 spoons of oil.
What oil did we
use? Grape seed oil, because I find that is more healthier than canola
grape
or any.
Oil.
Yep.
I never tried that. Did anyone else do it? I'm usually with olive oil.
Okay, let's see. Okay, now it's working.
You think she had to fight again, right?
Yeah. That's why I'm here. That's how they use me.
And abuse me. And we just a little bit saute the carrot, not fry it, not because we don't use any fry. This helps to remain really crunchy when you eat. It doesn't make like very small, like a puree, so we wait till we can hear that sound. Slowly we can hear how the carrots start to saute. It depends what kind of stove you use. It can be 1 to 2 minutes to wait. And the color of the oil, it became orange. So you see that nice, very, very nice color.
And orange is because of the carrots.
Yeah. And can I ask you, Nada?
Yes.
To bring me in this pot 2 liters of water.
2 liters of water?
Yeah. And I'm going to put on very low for another minute. And right away we fill it up with the water. Always you need to stir so it doesn't stick to the pan, doesn't fry. Coming with the water, we fill up with the water and we can add slowly the other ingredients. Yeah, we need to add to fill up.
Okay,
the water.
Need to pour in for
yeah,
you?
Thank you. Okay. And we add the water, we start to add using vegetal. So I didn't put any other salt because this already contains enough salt to give a taste. If you like with more salt, you can add separately. it depends everybody how it's like. If you like with less salt, you put less vegeta. Maybe you put one more piece of carrot, I mean one more carrot in plus or something, more vegetables.
I would just like to explain.
Yeah.
I would just like to explain, you can go to any store such as Fertino's, wherever they have things,
langos
and stuff like that, it says vegeta on, it's Yugoslavian, from ex-Yugoslavia, where I am coming from. It's really good for any kind of soups or if you are baking potatoes and you want to put that on, and so it gives you better taste. But
you can use
I wish,
base too.
Yes, I wish we, do you have by any chance the container?
I didn't bring.
Okay, next time we'll bring one so you see how it looks. But it's vegetables, there's nothing in, it's seasoning, it's just vegetables.
It's salt.
Dry vegetables and bit of salt, of course.
So we put the vegeta, I chopped up celery stalk. Now, again, the celery stalk, if you like more, you can put more, if you like less, or if you don't like at all, just keep it and put other kind of vegetables. We put the celery stalk in our soup. We have parsley root, again, parsley root, not everybody knows, and not you can't find everywhere. It's very same like the parsnip, but the taste a little bit is different. The parsnip is more sweet. So if you don't have parsley root, I know it's a little bit expensive, you can't find everywhere, just use parsley, the plain parsley. So we put our parsley root, we put our parsley, that's most common and everybody can find everywhere. The same thing, I like to chop everything in very small pieces so the kids can take out everything. And now we need to wait when we put all these vegetables till the water start to boil. When the water start to boil in around 5 minutes, if we put the lid on, we can add the beans. I have here the yellow beans. I don't know if you are familiar with. So we clean the edges, cut in small pieces, and I have over here the canned beans,
red kidney beans.
Now, if you use the soup, you can make soup just with the red kidney beans or white kidney or whatever beans you like. You can make the soup just with yellow beans or green beans, French beans, depend how you like it. You can mix them. Today we're gonna do the mixed one. So you mixed the dry bean with the green bean. Let's see how do you like the taste of this. In a few minutes our water is boiling. The time we wait, I just want to say that the beans contain almost 30% of protein, 30 gram of protein, the dried beans, what is very, very healthy for us. And near the protein, we have dietary fiber, what helping us in digestion, some lipids and minerals. We can have iron, potassium, sodium from the beans. And I don't know if you remember or if you hear, but the poorer countries, for them, the beans, it's a basic food they use because it's cheap, it's healthy, helping in digestion and contains a lot amount of protein. Practically fill their stomach, so they don't need to eat 4 or 5 times a day, maybe they eat 2 times. So that's why where I came from Romania, I remember lots of time, everybody, what you do? Bean soup, bean pasta, bean salad, bean, everything it's bean. And they used to eat with chopped onion. That was one of the hours.
And everyone was healthy.
Yeah.
No,
chopped
really.
Chopped onion, put a little bit of salt, and just eat with the bean soup or bean, or they used to eat baked beans and all kind of recipes with that. So I think slowly our water starts to, yeah. So we can put in the yellow beans with the canned beans because it's already it's boiled. It's not hard, not the hard, the dry bean. We're gonna wait a little bit so our vegetables and our bean get oiled, get soft. Because if we put, it's gonna mesh everywhere and it doesn't look nice. Doesn't when you serve, it's not the best. So we're gonna wait a little bit till everything gets oiled. In the meantime, I want to show you how we prepare the tomato sauce for the soup. Because in this soup, we're gonna put the tomato juice. Over here, I have homemade tomato juice. It's just plain tomato with a little bit of salt, and it gets a quick boil. This was actually canned for winter, so that's why it needs to be boiled before we can.
But you canned it.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And tomato from our garden, so it's everything very healthy. So I'm gonna put over this big pot for a minute. Lower the heat because we don't need so much heat for our tomato sauce. And we have over here two like very flat tablespoons of flour. I mean, we don't put too much. We use the flour and the remaining of 2.5-3 tablespoons of oil. We used around 4.
And why do you do that?
I do this because it gives a nice texture to the soup. It's like a creamy texture to the soup. I'm going to use this one over here.
Because if you don't do any flour to put in, your soup will be very watery. So it really doesn't...
With the flour, again, depend on the stove, depend on the heat, what kind of pot you use. You need continuously to stir and wait till you see bubbles, a few bubbles, but you don't keep it there because it's gonna burn. And right away when you see the bubbles, we're gonna add the tomato juice and continue to stir.
Do you want me to add tomato juice?
Yes, it's
ready. You ready for
yes,
it?
Yeah. The bubbles are there. We are ready. Yes, and just continuously stir so the flour doesn't make any
smoke. Put so back.
Yes, thank you.
Now, just remember in the beginning she said it takes 1 hour. We are not going to wait for 1 hour. We have a big pot of soup, so we are going to taste. But 1 hour would be way too much to wait for one soup.
So you always check if your beans or your vegetables are boiled, so they are soft enough. When they are soft enough, you add the canned beans. If you don't use the canned beans, you use just the yellow beans or the French beans, green beans, what you use, the French beans, you just check for them to be ready. So we add the beans too. And because they are already ready, they are cooked, you don't need to wait. In the same time, you can add the tomato, what you already prepared. And usually with the tomato juice, you boil it for about 5 minutes. So you see that it's boiling together. And that's all. It's easy. It's pretty quick. The only time that you need to wait practically is to be everything cooked properly. So you don't serve a cooked piece of beans or vegetables. Okay, and we're gonna bring in the back and
so
to continue.
It. She's
to
done.
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you. And I'm gonna present something to you what our family likes to and my children likes to. And I was buying sometimes already like vegan sausages from the store, and they're quite good. But I was thinking maybe I can do my own sausages, and I came up, you have here vegan sausages Italian. It's not because they came from Italy or something. It's just I use Italian seasoning, and you can feel that flavors. And that's why I put Italian. And we're going to start now. We're going to start from dry ingredients. You can see on your recipes. We're going to use wheatel with gluten flour. And I'm going to put in my bowl.
What kind of flour is this?
It's wheatel with gluten flour.
Gluten flour.
And then we're going to use our other dry ingredients. It's a nutritional yeast and sea salt, a little bit of vegeta, and smoked paprika, and also Italian seasoning, and granulated onions too. And I mix all of them here in this container, and I'm just gonna mix them all together. And as you know, it's a nutritional yeast, it's very healthy for you, and it gives a nice flavor to anything what you do. And actually, my favorite things, what my daughter likes, it's popcorn. Popcorn with the nutritional yeast, it just tastes so good.
Oh yeah, did you ever try with nutritional yeast popcorn?
Oh, wow.
So good.
It's really good.
You put a little bit, just sprinkle some oil and salt and nutritional yeast.
Beautiful.
It's just amazing. We do that every week. And we just mix that very well. And then we're going to start with our wet ingredients. And we're gonna you can take any blender. I have a Vitamix, I think that's the one of the best ones. And you can mix anything in this blender. And it's just perfectly good for that. And then we're gonna use our beans. And you can use any kind of beans what you like. But I prefer to use today pinto beans. But also you can use white kidney beans, you can use Romano beans, and it's good too. And then we're going to use our vegetable broth. You can make your own, or you can go also to find in the store. They have organic one, but I usually like make my own, and it's just like potatoes, carrots.
Just boil the vegetables.
All the veggies, yes, vegetables. And celery stalk. And we're gonna add there. And then we're gonna have olive oil. And we're gonna have tomato paste. And we're gonna have a soy sauce. And I also combine them all together here in this container. And we're gonna add there. And another ingredient, it's a garlic. Well, it gives a very nice flavor. And I use a raw garlic. You can use granulated garlic too, but I prefer to use raw. And I really like the garlic, and I use a lot in my cooking, and I use raw garlic. And now we're gonna put that on a blender. I need a lid. Sorry,
okay.
It's missing. And I'm gonna do on my Vitamix. You can use on a regular blender, and you're gonna just blend all these wet ingredients. I'm just gonna wait for that, please. I guess it's not a good idea to start right now. Thank you so much. And we're gonna cover that. And you know it's a little bit noisy, I hope the children will not be scared. I'm gonna start slowly. Oh! Give me a second, no. It should work. Any pieces in there, and I blend it very nice and smooth, as you can see. I mean, like you can leave. Sometimes you can, if you use other blenders, you can see other like pieces. If you don't use too long, and I prefer to blend it very well. That. And now we're gonna add that to our dry ingredients, and we're gonna mix that very well. And as you can see in your recipe, you're gonna leave it for a little bit, for 5-10 minutes, and then you're gonna mix again everything, and then you're gonna leave it for another 5-10 minutes. It needs, all this flavor needs to come to the gluten, yeah, to everything, it just combines very nice. And we're gonna mix that. And as you can see, now it's a little bit more, it has more liquid, but as it stays, it will come more harder, and it will be like a dough. I'm gonna show you now in a second. And this is how it looks. You can see it. It's not so runny, but it's still kind of, you know, a little bit
soft.
Let's say that. Yes. But you're gonna leave it that for about 10 minutes, and then you knead again, like just or mix one more time, and then you're gonna use your oil, and you're gonna use your parchment paper. And here I'm gonna show you a secret how to do that. I had a friend yesterday, and she's like, "How you are making this? It's so hard." But actually, it's not hard at all. You're gonna take your aluminum foil, but I don't prefer to put straight on my aluminum foil any food, and I usually always use my parchment paper. And you're gonna take your parchment paper, and you're gonna take a measurement cups, and you're gonna see what's best for you, works best for you. You can take smaller, bigger, you can make bigger sausages, you can make smaller. I'm gonna take a quarter of a cup, measuring cup, and then I'm gonna take one of these after when it stays like about 20 minutes. When the all the
now
flavors.
It's too runny, but later.
Yes, yes. Now it's a little bit too runny, and when it's gonna stay a little bit, it's gonna be more harder, like it's gonna be like a dough. And then you're gonna take, and you can just make. Shape it just a little bit, yeah, it's a little bit more soft now. And you're gonna just make it, just make a, like a sausage. Yeah, now it's just still a little bit soft. And you're gonna make it, you're gonna place it here, and then you're gonna roll that. Yeah, I'm gonna add a little bit more, sorry.
It's and too soft.
Yes, and it's too soft also. You need to have your parchment paper smaller than the foil, because when you're gonna see when you're gonna twist it, you don't need to have your parchment paper there. It's gonna make it even harder. And then you're gonna just roll it, and don't look if it doesn't look perfectly fine. Because when you put on a steamer and you steam it, it just pump, like, it just...
Oh, it fills out.
Fills out, yes. Mm-hmm. And it makes perfectly like a sausage size,
yeah.
And it looks like a sausage. And then you can just place it like that, and then you roll it, roll it. Don't roll it too tight, because it's going to pop up everything. And then you're going to make it like that. You're going to feel it towards the end. And just twist it from one side and from the other. Yeah, that's what I have mine. What I just want to show you the result. Like, and you can see this one. And then you're just going to put on your steamer. And you make sure that you have, I have here, I'm going to show you. I have, you have a plastic steamers, you have metal steamers, and I have like this, and you add a little bit of water inside, and make sure you have enough water for about 30 to 40 minutes, because it's going to simmer or boiling for about 30 to 40 minutes. And then you're going to place your sausages there, and you're going to boil that for about 30 to 40 minutes. And then I want to just show you the result, which, how it looks when already boiled, and the final product. You're gonna open, just twist it the same things back, untwist it, and then you're gonna open that. And you can see your parchment paper is all over the sausage. You don't have anything what connects to the foil. And you're gonna open, and you're gonna have a perfectly shaped sausage. And don't worry, I'm telling you, the gluten flour, usually when it cooks, it just...
Expands.
Yes. That's right. And that's what you have, and if you can show the final product too. And you can try to make these portions. It just like, it comes about, let's say, 10 of them.
Okay, this is how it looks, and we are going to taste that.
Yes, and you're gonna taste that. And it has a nice, I mean, like, you use nutritional yeast, you use your beans, and it's very, I mean, like, it's very nutritious for you, and you know what you put there, and you can enjoy it, you can give it to your children, and you know what is that and how you made it. That's it for the Italian sausages.
That's it for the sausages? You see how easy it is?
Thank you. Yes, sorry. I usually buy from the bulk barn.
Oh, okay.
But you can buy in Fortinas, you can buy in Zara's, you can buy in, they have like a packages. And or health food store, yes, the health food store, that's a very good idea too, yes, it's always there. But they, like, sometimes you buy in the packages, they have flax seeds, you know, organic or some, like, you know, like some seeds. And they also, like, smaller packages, they have gluten, wheat gluten.
I think flour. That Fortinos should have, because they do
sure.
have all kinds of different
and
things there.
Yes.
So they should have it.
Yeah.
So, and how many would that make, roughly?
It's about, let's say, about 10. 10 yeah. to 12 pieces of the sausage, like this size, yes,
exactly.
If you use the one quarter of a cup, yes. And if you make them smaller or bigger, it comes more or less, yes. And also, I'm telling you, you can place, if you're, you can work with your seasoning. If you like any other seasoning, what you use in-house, like or oregano, or you don't need to use just Italian seasoning. You can use it separately, like oregano, dried parsley, or rosemary, whatever you like. It just up to your taste.
When it comes to cooking, use your own imagination.
Yeah.
You can't go wrong. You'll eat it anyway. So just just experiment, and then when you find the best way for you, then use that. But as I said, you'll eat it anyway,
and also,
it's going to be good.
Yeah, sorry. And also, we are doing at home. If you find out, it's a little bit like the, some people, our family, we are okay with that, but some people, they're having a hard time with the gluten flour. And also, maybe next time, I'm going to try to see, I can present gluten-free sausages too. And it's you'll have like almost the same, like you steam it and you have beans there, but you use a rice flour and use other ingredients to make it a gluten-free. And they actually taste very good too.
Another cook is coming, and I told you in the beginning that we are very much international. This one is from where?
South Africa.
And she has that lovely English accent, not like me, European. So enjoy it.
Hi, today I'm going to be making an artichoke tapenade. It's nice and quick and easy, so.
You should move.
Let's start off with a can of artichoke hearts.
You boiled them before, or what?
No, just.
Oh, you buy them in a can.
You open it, and that's it.
That's it.
And half a cup of pitted green olives. A tablespoon of capers. A third of a cup of olive oil. A bit of salt. Two cloves of crushed garlic. A tablespoon of lemon juice, and 1/8 teaspoon of cayenne pepper.
Cayenne, that's good.
And then whiz it all up.
This is instant. Yes, go ahead. Question.
I noticed you have chili peppers. Cayenne is kind of different, right? I don't know what
you can use any pepper you want.
I've used paprika as well. That works really well.
Okay.
Yeah. And I have to tell you that she's a great cook, but you will taste with artichoke.
Tapenade.
Okay, tapenade. See, I told you, her English and mine, We are going to have it on her homemade bread. This woman makes bread that is out of this world. I don't know how she does it, but I just love it. And she didn't pay me to say that. So I think we are done with this.
Yeah.
Okay, and that was, like, we are generation that we want to have everything so quickly done. I don't have time when I come from work to do some elaborate. But this and piece of bread and nice salad, what else do you need? Okay, so you want to finish with dessert, don't you?
Absolutely.
And now, Julie will come out, and this dessert that she's doing, you don't have to bake. You just put together, and it's perfection.
And I'm back, as you can see. One more recipe, and that's the last recipe. And that's the best recipe, because it's sweet. Who likes sweet? I think everybody likes sweet.
You bet.
Yes. And today we're going to do something very, very nice. It's actually, it's very easy, it's so good, and you can use in many other ways. And I made it as a cake. And this is the cake you don't need to bake. And another thing you're using here, as you can see, from the ingredients, is almonds, dates, cashews, lemon, vanilla, coconut oil, coconut milk, raw honey and raspberries, and it's a very, very healthy. It will be a very healthy cake. Okay, and now we're gonna start it. I made it here to save a little bit time. Only the spoons. No, don't worry. Just don't worry. Just a little bit later. Here's I mixed for the mix everything for the crust in my Vitamix. It takes just like less a minute. Just
so
to blend that. It's almonds, dates, and a little bit of salt. And also, I add a little bit of water. If you can write it down in your papers, just add a little bit of water. Because it makes this, as you can see, it needs to stick like a paste, that's right, to make that crust. And it's going to be a very healthy. You see, it's just like, it stays there. And you're going to take your a cake pan, and you're going to put your parchment paper in there, and you're going to use this for your crust. You're going to take this, and you're going to spread and press it very nice, firmly, all over the bottom. And you're going to take that. And I use it for a little bit smaller of the cake pan. But this is a little bigger, it's good too, but you need to make sure you press everything firmly in every corner. And you're gonna see, I'm gonna show you, just give me a second, how it looks here. You just spread all over your pan. And then we're gonna start doing our fillings. We have two fillings today. We have vanilla filling and raspberry filling. It's very tasty and very good. That's right. You know me. You can read my mind. Thank you, Nara. And here we have now. Just make it very nice. Take your time. At home, you can make it nicer, like this. And you're gonna make everything in the bottom. Just make sure you cover all the space all over. And now, I'm gonna work on my vanilla and raspberry filling, and I'm not gonna put it in there. I'm gonna give it to you to try that. And I'm gonna use now a double portion. Just don't look at my portions because they're doubled. And you can use 1.5 cup of raw cashews. I use a Vitamix. I don't know how many of you have a Vitamix, but and I wrote it down on the recipe. But you need to soak at least for 5 hours or overnight. That helps when you're blending to have this smooth, very nice, creamy fillings. But on my Vitamix, I just wash them and I just gonna use like that. And it's just going to be blend very, very good, very good. I'm gonna use my 3 cups of cashews because I'm making double. And I'm gonna use my lemon juice. And also, can you write it down? There's a mistake. It's juice of 1 lemon, not 2 lemons. It's going to be a little bit too sour. If you like to have a little bit sour, yes, you can do, but it's only juice of 1 lemon. And then you're gonna add your lemon juice. And then I'm going to use my vanilla. And this is, I found in the health food store, it's organic vanilla extract, and it's non-alcoholic. I prefer this one, and I'm going to use it two teaspoons of vanilla. Okay, let's see. One and two. It gives such a nice flavor. And now we're going to use our coconut oil. As you can see, it's kind of soft. But if you're using in other blenders, it's better to leave it in a very warm place, or just place it in your pan and just warm it up to have a very, very like more liquid, that it will be more more soft, let's say like that. And this is the same things honey, and in Vitamix, I don't need that. I'm gonna use one of these spoons. I'm gonna clean up my spatula, and I'm gonna add that coconut milk. If you would like to use a coconut cream, that's going to be even better. And I prefer to use a coconut cream here, but it's sometimes hard to find it. And you need to use a coconut milk with full fat to have this fat, or just use a coconut cream. It's even better because it gives an even better taste. And I'm gonna put my coconut oil first. And it's also, you need to find, it's the best way to use organic coconut, you know that. And I also use organic raw honey. And it's a Canadian made, it's from Canada. Actually, I have a friend, they're having a bees, and they give it to me, a very, very best honey, what I really enjoyed. And I know it's raw, and I know there's no sugar and nothing else added there, and it's not heated. And now I'm going to use my coconut milk. And with coconut cream. What you have on top of your can, if you buy a full fat coconut milk. You make sure that you buy full fat coconut milk. And the raspberries, we're going to leave it till the end. We're going to add raspberries in there. And now we're gonna blend it. You're gonna see it. It's gonna be a little loud. Okay. In the end, we're gonna serve that. You know what? One friend I had last week, she came to me, and I was doing that for the pancakes. It's like you can use like your sour cream, vegan sour cream. And she came to me, and I was doing that. She didn't see what I put inside, and she said, "What is that? It's a condensed milk?" I'm like, "No, it's not a condensed milk. It's a real healthy sour cream. What I'm making for at home for my waffles, but at that time I was doing for my pancakes. And I'm gonna just blend it one more time. I just want to make sure that everything is smooth and nice, and I can see it just a little bit small pieces. And I'm gonna blend it one more time.
Should I bring a spoon so you put stuff in? Or?
Yes, please. Good for the children. As you can see, I didn't use any sugar here, and I didn't use any dairy here, and it's just very healthy, and I really enjoy that, and I think you never will find a better sour cream than that. It's just a very nice sweet sour cream for your pancakes and for your waffles. And what I'm gonna do it now, I'm gonna do that. You also can do, for example, I brought here, it's like you put a yogurt here. You can put half of the vanilla filling here, and also I'm going to give it to you to try with raspberry. And then you can use half of the raspberry. And or you can use this one as an ice cream. You're going to put in your ice cream, how is it, to freeze that.
Whatever addition you put in
there. Yes. And you freeze that, and it comes a very nice ice cream, because it's it just perfectly, like, you can feel that flavors, and it tastes just like real ice cream, but vegan. And now we're gonna use
I'll hold and you do it.
Yes. And if you have a question right now, you can ask me. And can you do it?
Yes.
Just, you know what? Just take every spoon and just put it in your
spoon.
Right. Yes.
Okay. No.
And later on, we're gonna add some raspberries, and it gives a very nice, a little bit sour flavor. But it
this
also
is gonna take for ages, Julie.
I'm so sorry.
She wants you to try, but
I did not.
I am messing it up, but it's good.
I didn't
go wrong with food.
I mean, like, I didn't want to give it just to put it here, and I want to give it a try.
She wants everything.
And I have also.
I don't think it's gonna happen.
The final result here, and it's one of the thing. It comes cold because we put that in the freezer or at least in the fridge, and it comes a little bit cooler. And that's why I want to give you when it's still not frozen and still tastes just original. has original taste. And that's the final product.
You guys are laughing, but I'm having fun.
Why don't you get a garden hose?
Thank you. You want to come here and help?
Pastry bag.
Yeah. Something.
And yeah, it takes a little bit of time. Let's see what.
That was not in my contract.
Yes, sorry. Yeah, I didn't tell you that before. So sorry about that. And what else I can add here? And you just yes, that's
you
what
do your
when you put in your cake pan, you're gonna put this vanilla filling, and you're gonna put that in the freezer for about 20 minutes. That this crust, because of the coconut oil and because of the coconut milk, but it has a coconut cream inside, it's gonna mix a little bit harder.
Excuse the mess, but.
And then you're gonna put your raspberry filling on top.
Did you double the recipe? Like all the ingredients, did you double to put it in that size?
I doubled, yes. I doubled all the ingredients there because I was not sure how many people was going to be, and I want to make also with raspberry. And as you can see, it's maybe a little bit sweet. You can adjust how much you want the honey in there, but I mean, that's what I use at home, and it also you can use it a little bit less.
Thank you.
I mean, like, it's sweet. It's just when you use in your waffles and when you use in your pancakes. I mean, I think that's one of the best sauce what you can get. And I was trying to make, to be honest, I was trying to make it the tofu, tofuti, Any other things, like to have this sweet, I mean like sweet sauce on my waffles, on my anything like what I like to use. And, sorry, I'm gonna move that. I'm moving that.
Oh, yeah, like, sorry people.
No, I have to.
She is very ahead of me.
Sorry,
I'm gonna do it like this.
Okay.
How many?
Two?
Tomorrow. Sorry. It's coming.
And I just love these things. It's just very sweet and you don't use zero sugar. And it's, I mean, like, for even for small children, it's just perfectly. And now we're gonna add raspberries and you're gonna taste of the raspberries.
Do I have to do this
raspberries
too?
Yep. I'm
gonna
help you.
Frozen raspberries. It comes like ice cream, to be honest. It's a very native ice cream. And it just tastes a little bit, it has this little bit of sour flavor from the raspberries. You can use fresh raspberries, and also you can use frozen raspberries. And I'm gonna do that now. I'm gonna give it to you to try, and it's just, you're gonna have a cake too, you're gonna have a chance to try a cake, but I mean, this is just kind of a little appetizer, let's say that, a sweet appetizer. I don't know if we had ever sweet appetizers, but now you do. And we're gonna take, and now as you can see, it's very thick and it comes more like an ice cream. And that's what I was telling you, if you have children and if you want to make your homemade ice cream and vegan and sugar-free and everything and dairy-free, that's one of kind.
Oh, again?
I always finish that.
But this one is not as messy, so
I know.
I can live with that. You need more spoons?
I need more spoons.
More spoons, please. Okay, whatever is done, I'll bring it over.
Thank you.
No, this one is not bad.
No, this is
not bad.
Because it has the frozen raspberries, and that what gets this almost like ice cream.
Can I take this one?
Yes, thank you. And I think even my daughter, Melanie, Emily, would you like to have some ice cream? She's busy. She's busy. She's watching hockey. She likes that. She likes that hockey things. Soccer, hockey, gymnastics, whatever it is. She's very
hot. Yeah, she knows what she's doing. Okay, Julia, you ready with next?
Yes, I am. And that's one of the things what my children like. I have two girls, and the older one, she's 5, and the younger one, she's 2 and 2 months. And that's why I use for them like something sweet, that they can have something like ice cream or pancakes or just in the evening, in the morning, whatever. Even on cereal, she likes even on cereal that, like instead of the milk, I'm like, it's sweet. And I think all the children like the sweet. And do you need more? And also I'm telling you, you can use as your yogurt, like a dessert, you can use in any kind of cups, like, I mean, different shapes, and you can layer your fillings, and it can be even more.
No, I think.
Okay.
And that. Okay, I think we are.
Yeah, that's the recipe for that. Yes.
I just wanted to ask, if it's a mixture, and you said to put the mixture on top of the crust, and then keep it there in the fridge for 20 minutes for, and then put the raspberry.
That's right. That's right. And when you have vanilla filling, you need to divide in two. And one part you're going to put on your crust and put in the freezer and just wait for 20 minutes. And while that, you can blend it another half of your raspberries. And that one comes like that. And when you cut, that's what it's very important. When you cut your cake, it's going to be perfectly like a straight line between vanilla filling, between raspberry filling. If you're gonna add at once together, it's gonna be like, you're gonna have these waves, more vanilla flavor or more raspberry flavor. That's it for now. Thank you.
So that's our last recipe. I hope you enjoyed it. Pretty soon we are going to taste it. I'm sorry for those that came a bit late, but you do have all the recipes there. And you will be able to try whatever we were presenting. And before
thank you once again for coming. So we usually, if you don't mind, we usually, before we eat, we like to say grace. So if you don't mind, so we'll just say grace.
Let us just bow our heads.
Father in heaven, thank you for giving us this opportunity and for providing food. And we thank you for this food. We ask you to nourish our bodies. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
So now we invite you to try the sausages, the soup, this.
And if you don't want to take everything at once, you can come back and...